I'm from Anhui University. This paper is about a fractional Fourier transform algorithm for the holographic display. First, the introduction. As you know, holographic display is the most advantage of the three-dimensional display technology, which has become the popular topics in the field of optical and computer research. Face-owning hologram calls for concern because the diffraction efficiency can reach 100% in the ideal case. In order to obtain face-owning hologram, firstly, face-owning information of constant amplitude calculated by the original wave, which is also known as phase retrieval. There are two types of numerical algorithms of phase recovery. First is iterative, and second, the direct solution of equations of transmission intensity. It has become one of the major research methods that using iterative numerical algorithm for phase retrieval based on the intensity of light. And in 1972, the GS iterative algorithm was proposed by Gershberg and Section. And improved algorithms such as RE, IO, and BIO, YG, and so much come forth on the basis of GS. However, these algorithms have iterative uncertainty, poor anti-noise performance, and other shortcomings, such as of slow convergence. And fractional Fourier transform was put forward in the 20th last century and was introduced to the field of optics in the 90s. Compared to traditional Fourier transform, fractional Fourier transform is more general, flexible, and convenient to deal with, and also intrinsically linked with the Fresnel diffraction. And a Fourier transform can be used to describe the far field diffraction, and the fractional Fourier transform is used to describe the near field diffraction. The research of fractional Fourier transform in recent years has made great improvement, which has brought new opportunities for the optical information processing technology. And in this paper, iterative fractional Fourier algorithm was used to get a face-owning complex wave. If using of conventional coding method, such as detour phase coding method to encode a wave function, the zero order diffraction spots are very difficult to emulate. And for the larger pixel images, it's rather difficult to have a good hologram. And in this paper, binary coding method is adopted to emulate the zero order diffraction in theory. Hologram beta can also be generated for the larger pixel images. The generated hologram was reconstructed with DMD, finally. In this paper, three contents the main content of the paper is about these three contents. The first is iterative fractional Fourier algorithm was used to get a face-owning complex wave. The second is the binary cosine coding method was used to generate binary face-owning hologram. And the third is the generated hologram was reconstructed with a DMD holography display system. And first, the fast fraction Fourier transform algorithm. And let us suppose the input signal is fx. This equation is the one-dimensional p order fractional Fourier transform. This is a pure mathematics equation. And the p is the fractional order. The fractional Fourier transform equation is always denoted as this equation. But there's also others. According to Lohmann's, the second type optical path, that's a two-length optical path, like this. We can get another form of p-order fractional Fourier transform equation. This equation is according to the Lohmann second type optical path. In this path, the F1 is the standard focus length, and the z is the distance between two lenses. According to this equation, we can get a fast algorithm of fractional Fourier transform. The flowchart is as follows. This is the flowchart of the fast algorithm fractional Fourier transform. In fact, there are three steps of this fast algorithm. The first step is phase transform of the first lens. The second is free space Fresnel diffraction, and we use angular spectrum method. And the third step is phase transform of the second lens. In this flowchart, the M denotes the object plane. This M denotes the Fourier plane, and this M deforms the fractional Fourier transform plane. In fact, this fast algorithm is based on the FFT. We use the fast fractional Fourier transform to iterate the phase of the original wave. This is the iterative fractional Fourier transform process, just like the traditional iterative Fourier transform process. The difference is here and here. Here is the fractional Fourier transform, not the FFT. And here is the inverse fractional Fourier transform. This is the original wave, the wave function. After the fractional Fourier transform, we get the spectrum of it. And we constrain the amplitude to a constant, always is a unit constant. That means A equals 1. And keep to the phase, phi. Then we get the another spectral, like this. Here. A is unit. That means we get a phase-owning wave. Then we use the inverse fractional Fourier transform here. After the inverse fractional Fourier transform, we get this wave function. And also we constrain the amplitude to the original amplitude and keep the phase. And this process goes on for more and more. In this work, there are about 500 times of the iterative process. And after the iterative process, we get the phase-owning wave function. And then the binary coding of cosine. That means when we get the wave function of the phase-owning wave function, how we get a hologram. Someone calls the phase-owning function a kilogram. But we want to reconstruct the hologram in a DMD. So we want to encode the phase. As we know, a phase-owning wave function, fx, can be expressed as this. According to the Euler formula, it can be expanded to this equation. The conjugate function of fxy can be expanded to this equation. And so from two above equations, we see that the cosine theta equals this one. That means the equation contains the phase-owning wave function and its conjugate wave function. So the coding is if cosine theta is positive or larger than zero, let cosine theta equals one. If cosine theta is negative or smaller than zero, let cosine theta equals zero. That's the coding of cosine. I call it the binary coding of cosine. The encoded image contains only phase-owning wave function and its conjugate wave function without any zero-order items. The so-called binary code is to encode wave function into black and white grayscale holograms. That is, the value of the hologram transmittance function is zero or one. After that, we get the binary phase-owning hologram. This is the original image. This is a panda, and this is the hologram, the binary phase-owning hologram. And this is the reconstructed image by the computer. And finally, we reconstructed this hologram in DMD. DMD, that is digital micro mirror device, is a product manufactured by TI. The DMD we used contains 800 multiply 600 micromirrors. And each pitch is 60 micromirror multiply 16 micromirror tiltable aluminum mirrors. The gap between each adjacent mirror is 1 micrometer. And this is our DMD holographic display system. This is the DMD. And this is the laser, the special filter. And the reconstructed image via DMD is like this. This is only one order. We take a photo of it. The others is cut. That's my little work of the holography. Thank you.
question or comments? Questions and comments.
Excuse me, you said that you made 500 iterations to calculate the image. You said you made 500 iterations. 500 iterations. My question is, what is the refreshing rate of the images? Okay, what is the refreshing rate? You perform one image and after that you, what is the time interval between showing both images, the next image, the refreshing rate? How many images you can show per second? Okay, maybe we'll discuss later, yeah.
How many images, image display, Mr. Second, just like the video, like DMD, this is the kinds of video, just the same as a video. We will talk.